What's up, guys? Welcome back once again to the Gaming Careers YouTube channel, where we aim to teach you everything that you need to know about live streaming and about content creation within the gaming niche. Now, in today's video, we're going to be talking about how to add a nifty little stream schedule plugin into your Twitch page. So this module is going to show not only your schedule and what it looks like for the coming week, but also it's going to convert that schedule into the viewer's local time zone, and it's going to show a countdown to your next stream. Sound good? Let's dive in. Just before we jump into the software, I want to quickly mention a few people have reached out to me and said that they haven't received my latest video in their subscription boxes. And I know that this is a problem all around YouTube. And really the only way to guarantee that you're going to get my new videos is to head to my channel and click the bell notification icon. Of course, other advice I would give is to follow me on Twitter and my Discord, because I always post my new videos on there. But unfortunately, it just seems that you need to take these extra steps on YouTube at the moment to be able to guarantee that you see my latest videos. Right, with that out of the way, I think it's worth just briefly talking about why having a schedule is such an important part of growing your audience as a streamer. And you've probably heard this advice all over the internet, but having a regular and consistent schedule is going to be one of the most important factors in growing your stream. If you look around at Twitch and you look at some of the big streamers, you'll notice that every single one of them has some sort of schedule that they try their best to keep to. And that is because you need to be letting your audience know exactly when they can expect to watch you and what days and what time you're going to be online. If people stumble across your stream and they like what they see, but you have no consistency in your schedule, you probably just lost yourself a potential regular viewer for your stream, since the next day at the same time when the same viewer is back on Twitch wanting something to watch, you aren't streaming. Now, I'm not saying here that you need to be streaming, you know, 14 hours a day, 7 days a week, because I know that that's not realistic. But if you can set some sort of schedule that, you know, you advertise on your Twitch page, and even if it's just a couple of hours a night and maybe a couple of nights a week, that is going to massively increase your chances of building a regular audience. So enough chit chat, how do we get this sweet looking panel configured and embedded onto our Twitch channel page? First things first, head over to the Twitch website and log in. Hit the little drop down up here and head across to your dashboard. Next, on the left hand side, we're going to click on extensions, and we want to search for the extension here by typing in schedule. This should hopefully filter the results, and you should be able to see this extension called Streamlabs, Stream Schedule and Countdown. If we click on details, we should get a brief description as well as a screenshot of the extension. So if it looks something like this, you've found the right one and you can click install. Now you should get a pop-up saying that the extension was successfully installed, but it needs to be configured and activated before it will actually display in your panels on your channel. So let's click configure and set up the options. The first thing that we get to configure is the color of the highlighted text. So this is the color of the countdown text, as well as the schedule text in the panel. Now, hopefully if you've been following some of my other videos, you have heard me recommend that you need to try and brand as much of your channel as consistently as possible. So things like color scheme, fonts, all those kind of things are, you want them to be as consistent as possible. So here I would definitely be using the color that makes the most sense for you and your brand. For me, this is going to be the red that I use in all of my avatars and channel banners. And I can just paste in the hexadecimal value here. Next, we will add our scheduled start times for each of the days of the week. I'd recommend adding your regular schedule that you can commit to in here. So for example, let's say that my schedule is that I start streaming at 4 p.m. in my local time from Tuesday to Friday and maybe at 11 a.m. on a Saturday. I'm going to uncheck Sunday and Monday since in this made up example, I don't stream on those days. Next, we have an option to set a stream break. So this is useful for holidays or other times that you're not going to be able to be keeping to your schedule. So when this is checked, your viewers will just see no upcoming streams in the panel instead of your schedule. You can also set an end date and time here for when you are back from your break and you are ready to re-enable the schedule. Finally, we have the option to set our local time zone. So this is needed so that the extension can then convert your times to the other time zones for your viewers. So the cool thing about this extension is that you enter the streaming times in your own local time, but the extension will then convert the time to your viewers based on what their computer clock is displaying. So if somebody from the other side of the world is a fan of your stream and they're watching at 7 a.m. in their local time, the schedule will show all of the starting times that you set in their local time to them. So for me, I'm based in London, England, So I'm going to find that option and click Save Settings. Once the settings are saved, we can click the little back arrow to go back to our extensions page, and we should see the Streamlabs schedule and countdown extension installed here over on the left. All that's left to do now is to activate it by clicking the Activate dropdown and then set it to be used as an extension panel. Or if you haven't got any set up yet, you can just add a new one. If everything has worked correctly, you should see a pop-up saying that the extension is now active. So if you head over to our channel page, we should see our newly configured stream schedule with a countdown to the next stream. This will now display to all of your viewers, so if they come to your stream page when you're not streaming, they're going to see this schedule as well as a countdown to your next stream. If you are live when they arrive at your page, the schedule will still show, but it will also show that you are currently live and it won't be showing a countdown. Hopefully, now you have followed this quick example and you have a stream schedule embedded into your Twitch page. And I promise that if you follow the schedule and keep to it as much as you can, as well as following a lot of the other tips that we share on this channel, you should see your stream grow. If you have enjoyed this video, please do give it a thumbs up. That helps us know what kind of content you guys like watching and learning from, and we can create more of that for the Gaming Careers community. Speaking about creating content, I would like to give a massive thanks to the patrons of the Gaming Careers channel this month. These people here are supporting the creation of these videos by pledging small amounts of money every month. So if you would like to also join them in supporting even as little as a dollar, all of that money gets funded back into the creation of these videos, and you can check all of that out at patreon.com/gamingcareers. Finally, I would like to say welcome to the newest members of the Discord channel. I think we're at nearly 500 members in the Gaming Careers community Discord now. So if you haven't yet joined, please do, and subscribers, I'll see you in the next video. Peace.